We have been deluged with national coverage about Bill de Blasio being at odds with the police department, the NYPD in his city. This obviously in the wake of the brutal murder, execution-style murder of those two Brooklyn police officers. But all of the talk and the chatter and the writing and the segments about the mayor of New York City make me think about something, which is, what if Bill de Blasio was the mayor of L.A. or Houston? Or Miami or Boston and would at odds with his local police force. Do you think it would have gotten 1% of the national coverage that it has received? Now, obviously, when you become the mayor of the Big Apple, that's a national platform, you can expect a lot of national exposure and national criticism. But I think something more is at work here, which is New York is the nation's media capital. And so Bill de Blasio is the mayor of people who work for Fox News and NBC and ABC and CBS and the Wall Street Journal and, of course, the New York Times and the New York Post. And so, in a way, the old phrase about all politics being local, I think one of the reasons that there has been so much intensive focus on what's a legitimate news story, Mayor de Blasio's many problems since winning a landslide election just over a year ago with 72% of the vote and now struggling to lead the city, a lot of this also strikes me as parochial because it all is local for the people, the journalists, the commentators, the TV types, the people who work for Time Magazine, all those folks who live there. Quick question. There is a new mayor inaugurated this week here in Washington, D.C. How many people around the country know that person's name? How many journalists beyond the Beltway know that person's name? It's Muriel Bowser. But Washington, and obviously she hasn't taken office yet, doesn't get the kind of intensive scrutiny at the local level, unless you're Marion Barry and you get caught smoking a crack pipe, that New York gets. And I learned this as a reporter in New York years ago when the case, the infamous case of the Central Park jogger took place. Initially, I thought this was a terrible, awful crime, a woman who was attacked while jogging in the park at night. And a bunch of young men were prosecuted, and later there were questions raised about their prosecution. Didn't seem like a national story to me, and suddenly it went viral, it went national. This is even before there was much of an internet, or before Twitter and before Facebook, and I realized everything that happens in New York is magnified, whether it's Donald Trump, whether it's Ed Koch at the time, Al Sharpton, when he was just a New York political figure, quickly became a national figure because they're in New York and because New York has such a concentration of media. And this also occurred to me the other day when Mario Cuomo died. I covered Mario Cuomo for part of the time, his three terms as governor. He was a guy who, as other reporters have observed, would call you at home and talk for an hour in an age when politicians still did that, sometimes yell at you over something you had written or argue and spin and all of that. That got a lot of national coverage. And look, Mario Cuomo was a national figure in the 1980s as an eloquent spokesman for liberalism, whether you agree with him or not. He was a guy who, everybody in the business thought was going to run for president until the last minute he did not. He was a guy who was in line to be appointed to the Supreme Court by Bill Clinton until the last moment he pulled back. There wasn't anything particular that he accomplished in his three terms as governor. It's that he was a New Yorker, and therefore he had a national platform, and he made use of that. So we all ought to keep that in mind when we see this surplus of New York stories. Look, I'm a New Yorker. I think everything that goes on in the city is fascinating. But there is a little bit of, well, this happened down the block, so it must be interesting to everybody else, like people who live in New York and have access to the great media platforms of New York City. And we're back here next week with more After the Buzz.